So this is another tutorial, and in this tutorial we're going to see how we can make a product. This product is an USB flash drive, which you will see here. So this is a product which we are going to make inside this video, and it has been a long time since I have published a tutorial, and this will be an introduction to how you can make a hard surface modeling inside Blender 3D. I'm using the version which is 2.79. We will make a couple of series, and we will later use the new version, which is 2.81, which is the latest release. So let's get started, and I have made a reference for us, which is this one. So basically this is in meters, and you can go to the scene and choose this meters, not empirical, because empirical is an inches, and I'm not going to work with inches. So basically we have this which is around 4 centimeter in the x-axis and 1.5 in the y-axis. Alright, so I will extrude 0.005, which is 5 millimeter in this axis, and after that I will make the here I will explain. So we have this part and we have this part. So this is the highly detailed part in our model. So I will leave for the final part, but I will start from this connections, which is I think type C connections for iPhone, and this is the cover for the USB flash. So I will duplicate this face. Let's go here, and I will duplicate this one. So I will duplicate, and after duplication I will select this one, so we can name it main geometry, and let's go it to name it type C connector, and after that I will extrude maybe 4 millimeter, extrude in x-axis to this distance, or 0.004 millimeter, and after that I will scale shift x 0.8 or 0.7, and maybe scaling in y 1.1, and after that we want to make something. We want to make it to be curved here. So I will delete or add. So I have added an loop cut here, and I will delete this part and add the mirror modifier because it's very symmetrical, and I will add the mirror and on the y-axis, and after that I will select this face, shift S cursor to selected, and delete this face, and after that I will select this edge and go here. You should be in the right also, and I will click Alt R and go to the this angle and make it minus 90 degrees, and we can go for 8 edges, and after that I will. So we are now done, and I will select each two vertices and Alt M merge at center, and as you can see we are here. We have two vertex from the total number of vertex, which is 24. So I will merge in the center, and here also we have two vertex, and I will merge in the center, and we have this open face. We don't to make it feel like this, because if you add the subdivision surface you will see this problem, but I will delete this face, and I want to make some edges here, 1, 2, we want two more here and two more here, and you can select this and fill like this, and if you want to make it much faster I will select this one and shift S cursor to selected, and go to the object mode and control alt shift C origin to the, after mirroring we will apply the mirror. Don't apply the mirror, I will select this vertex, shift S cursor to selected, and add the origin to the 3D cursor. So I will delete this part to mirror again in the x-axis. So we will add this one and mirror in the x-axis like this, and we are now done for this part, and we can dissolve this edge. Alright, so we are now done, and what I am going to make is to select these two faces and extrude in the x-axis like this. So I think we can scale in the y.9, enable clipping, and let's go to the right view, and after that I will scale in this part by going to selecting these edges and going here, and alright, I will disable the mirror for a moment, and I will see that there is some issues here, so I will delete these faces, and again let's reactivate the mirror, and this is USB Type-C. So I think if you have searched online for an USB Type-C connector or jack for iPhone, you will see this type of connection. And after that, I will duplicate all these elements for our reference and move to our final layer, which is the 20 layer, which is here. And I will save for now. So I will select this vertex and add some loop cut here. And add another loop cut here. And I think we are now close to add our mirror modifier, and after that I will activate the subdivision surface to see what we have, and basically you want to get some curve here. So how we can going to make this curve happen, I will select all these vertex and Alt S, let's scale Shift Z like this, and move in the x-axis like this. Alright, and after that, scale in the Y, let's make it curve like this. Alright, let's move to the next part. We want to make some area here as in the type C. So I will select this edge and move in the x-axis, and after that, right, after that we will extrude here around 1 millimeter, so minus, I think it's larger than 1 millimeter, so it's let's make it G and Z to this distance, and add some loop cut here, and after that we will add another connectors here. So let's see what we will get. I will activate the shading to be smooth, and maybe right, so I will make the, let's try to remove doubles. So already we was in doubles, so I will add select this face which is here, and make the cursor selected, and add an plane. This plane will be large, so I will scale in this area until we get this one. I think we have around 10 edges here, so I will scale in the X and scale in the Y, scale in the X, and after that we can I have added 2 edges here, and after that I will select this one and extrude in the Z. and let's control L scale in the Z to around 0.8, and after that I will add an array for this one. So let's select this one and add an array in the Y axis to be around 2.1, and this one will be 0, and you have 10, not 12. After that we can move in this axis . All right, let's refine this edge. So I will add some edges here and another edge here, and I think now we are done for this USB Type-C connector. So let's move to the next part. This time we will move to the cover. We will make the cover, which is here. This cover is very very simple, and let's go to the modeling. So we will start from here, and I will select this one and duplicate in the Z and separate by selection. After that I will move in the Z axis 4 times, and I think I have forget to activate the screencast keys. So I will go to the user preferences, and now I will activate the screencast keys. Alright, let's go to making this cover, and I think it should go for this direction, and it will cover this area which is here. So let's go to this time, and after that we will So I will select the plane and select mirror, and mirroring using this object and in the Z axis. And after that I will select let's extrude in the Z and enable the clipping, and shift S cursor to select it, delete the vertex, and using this edge in the front view to Alt R around minus 90 degrees, and maybe 90 only. This steps will be 4. Alright, let's go now, and we will scale in the Y 1.1. After that I will apply the mirror modifier, and let's select all edges which is here, and let's select also extrude scale shift x 0.9, scale shift y 0.85, and in the front view we want to go up to this moment, and scale in the X axis to be 0, and we want to select all these elements, and I will make them like this, and I want to make the same curve there. So I think it's longer, so I will move in the X axis to be here. Alright, I want to make some curve here in the final part. So I will control R, I will make a curve. And I think if we go for 5, it will be, or 4, it will be fine. and I will select all these elements and go here and select this other elements and go here. After that, I will scale in the Z little bit like this. Alright, I think we are now done. If you want to become much more efficient, you can add some detail. Basically, in our general or the original design, we have something. So I will enable the proportional editing for a moment, and in the x-axis, I will move it to be here, and let's select all these vertex and move here. We want only to emulate the original design, so let's select all these parts and move like this. And let's select this one. Alright, I think we are now done, but we will add the solidify modifier, which will add some thickness. As you can see, the thickness is more large. Also, 1 millimeter is very large, so we will decrease it until we find some value. So we will go like this. We want it to be in the inner part. Alright, so let's go for 0 for a moment, and I think we have some other option. Let's select all, and I will duplicate it and move some copy here. And let's try to extrude and Alt S to see what we will get. And maybe scaling. And after that, I will scale in the Y.9. And after that, let's go back and scale in the Z. And of course, you should for the normals, you should ignore the normals. And I think we are now done for this part, which is a cover, of course. And if you want to add some edges here to define these edges, it will be much useful. And if we go here, you will see that we are now done for this part. Alright, don't forget to add the smooth shading, which is like this. Alright, now we will move to another part, but we select the cursor to the center and add this part to make it like this, and it will be much better. Alright, so we will now make another final highly detailed thing, which is this USB connector. Basically, this is original USB, but I think it's an opened USB. Or this visual want to make you sense for the detail of this USB. So because we will make an close up shots, so I will make the USB in the next part. So that's conclude for this video. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. See you in the next part.